Namaste, I'm Pralhad Giri, welcoming you in a special edition of a special guest's interview. The Nepalese Film Development Board has an opportunity to honor the living legend of Indian cinema and heartthrob of millions of people around the world and Evergreen Star Dev Anand in Nepal. We have an opportunity to talk with him. Let's talk with him. Welcome to you, Dev Sahib.
Thank you.
How do you feel to be here in Nepal after you visited Nepal 30 years back?
I think it's a great honor because I've been wanting to come to Nepal because I've not been here for the last 30 years, since the time I made my last two pictures. And then I've been hearing about Nepal, I've been reading about Nepal, my mind has been with Nepal all the time. And I was seeking an opportunity as to when I would go and meet everybody, including His Majesty, and pay my respects to him. And suddenly this invitation came, and I said yes.
Over this year, there has been change in Nepal. Do you overview and whole world has been changed?
I went to see all the locations that I shot in, and they seem bigger and larger, and there's a lot of development. I can pinpoint the spot where I shot, but the surroundings have changed. They have new structures have come in. And I think it's very natural because when the development takes place and years pass by, things do happen.
So how did you feel having received this award?
I was very deeply touched.
Yeah. Previously, it is said that you're quite close with late King Mahendra.
If I was not close to King Mahendra, I would not be able to make Hare Rama Hare Krishna in my other picture. Destiny had put us together. And destiny had chalked out a plan for me, and I made Hare Rama Krishna, and that was my first contact with the people of Nepal, with the Nepalese culture, with the township of Nepal, Bhaktpur. Then the second picture up in the mountains. So things are laid out.
You have a good relation with His Majesty of Nepal. You visited in Hare Rama Hare Krishna with late His Majesty King Mahendra. How do you feel here, recent our King Gyanendra?
I think since I knew the father, and I know the sons, and my affinity and my tremendous warm-heartedness, my tremendous feeling for the royal family. They're like my own family, and I look forward to that. And I met him last evening, and my heart was full of a lot of affection. And I'm meeting him this evening, and I'm exchanging a lot of wonderful notes. And when I came to shoot the picture here, he was a young prince. I remember he was watching from a distance at Shambhu and I was shooting, and somebody said, "This King, young Prince Gyanendra." I walked up to him, I said, come behind the camera. I said, no, I don't want to disturb you. Now, that's my image of him.
There has been a trend in the Indian cinema. You promoted Miss former Miss India, Gina Thaman, in Hare Rama Hare Krishna. There are so many Miss India's, Miss Beauty Queens are coming in films, Indian cinema. How do you feel? Is this kind of a good thing?
I've finished a film called Mr. Prime Minister, which is finished. And I'm releasing it in Diwali all over the world. And I bring it here for the people to see. That film is a satire on my political system in my country. That's what I am. I make films that are happening all over the world. And then my new film is Beauty Queen, for which I need two girls and a boy. I've signed a girl in Bombay. I've signed a boy in Bombay. I still need a girl, a hell of a part. And I want to do it in two versions, English and Hindi. And you never know, there could be a girl here.
Can it be a girl in Nepalese girl also?
Why not? I think you got some beautiful faces.
So you visit?
It can happen. If it happens, then I think it's something outstanding. If it happens, then anything can happen. This I think you got to go along with the world. Because now the audience is the world audience. You got to get across your boundaries and be known all over the world. Because cinema medium is a medium that belongs to the people of the world. That's what I'm telling you motion picture makers also. Don't get buried. Don't be desperate. Suddenly one of you will make a great film, and then the great film will be recognized in the International Film Festival. And there you are, you made it, and the world comes. And suddenly a movie is made here, all of a sudden, in Nepal. Either in collaboration or as a Nepalese production, or somebody comes and makes a big picture here and that makes a big mark, the whole world would come and flock. Now we want to make pictures here. So it's a world phenomenon. And motion picture making is the best profession in the world. Everybody loves motion pictures.
So can you say me, what is the main thing to make a good film? What is to be taken into consideration?
I think the story, the story, the thought, there should be a soul in your picture, and then of course technique comes later. how the subject is handled by the director, mm-hmm. and how the stars perform, what sort of music. So everything gets together in a wonderful way, and all the cogs of the wheel fit in properly, and you have a great motion picture.
In recent years, your films has not been commercially successful. What's the reason behind that?
No, but I think because I've been tackling different types of themes. Which is my own growth is I'm tackling different types of themes, and it takes people time to get to the theme.
But nowadays, because this is the era of commercial.
No, but how do you know? Can you plan a commercial film? Nobody can plan it. It happens. There are only two blockbusters. And now I'm very hopeful about my new film, Mr. Prime Minister.
Directors in India like Mahesh Bhatt has been making films related with the vulgarity. I mean, it is in total full of the sex and this kind of stops. So nowadays, but how this kind of things will lead the cinema?
I think sex and violence, if it's required in the picture, people will take it. If it's not required in a certain story, I think becomes senseless. But if it's required, it's required. Depends upon the subject matter that you're picking up. But if you make a film completely on sex, mm-hmm. depending upon sex, it will not click.
But then where the Indian film industry is going, moving?
I think I'm very optimistic. It's going where it should go. It's growing like any other industry.
Then you are happy. That was in 1950s years. That was in the Indian cinema. That was quite successful.
I'm very happy because I think Indian film movie industry is growing. It's growing bigger and larger and touching international arenas. And watch next 2, 3 years, 4 years, bigger things will happen. Even in Nepal, your directors who are doing the pictures now, they'll be doing better pictures tomorrow.
व्यवस्थापनको लागि हामी आज पश्चिम पनि पूर्वतिर हेरिरहेका छौँ हामीसँग हाम्रा पुर्खाहरूले एउटा सम्पदा छोड्नु भएको छन् त्यो सम्पदा आज त्यसको मूल्य पश्चिममा बढिरहेछ त्यो हो यो
सोचु बोल्दै बोल्दिन सुने मान्छे सँग दिल खोल्दै खोल्दिन मुसुक हाँसी देऊ फूल फुले झैँ ओ पानी परे पछिको आकाश खुले झैँ
हाय आई एम कुमार सानो यु आर वाचिङ मी एनटिभी टु मेट्रो
So many Indian films has been shot in Nepal. You also shot Hare Rama Krishna in so many films here. Cannot Nepal be developed as a destination of making movies? But why Bollywood producers, actors are reluctant to come to Nepal?
You see, they come for a few songs, which has no meaning. They can go for a few songs to any country. But
what are the major reasons do you find? Not coming in Nepal. I mean, they are going to Switzerland and so many expendable.
It's not deliberate. Maybe it never struck them. Maybe once they come here and start making films, then they realize the potential of Nepal, which I realized because I've been in touch with the whole situation in Nepal, the Nepalese backdrop, the Nepalese locales, and the cooperation, the sentiment. They are not fortunate enough to be exposed to that era. I was lucky because I did those pictures. And I've come back, and my now mind is totally refreshed again. You never know, anything can happen. I'm starting in my own range. I've crossed all. I'm beyond a superstar. Look, I'm a thinker. I'm a maker. I'm a star. I'm an actor. I'm a director. I'm a writer. I'm behind the camera. I'm in front of the cameras. I'm picking up themes.
No, I mean to say that why this label is being given to the stars? I mean, mega star, king star, superstar.
It's all publicity. Publicity stunts everybody. Once you're known to the world, you're a star. There's no such thing as a mega star. I mean, people can enjoy themselves and they can dance. But a star is a star is a star. Shining in the high, shining bright in the hearts of people is the definition of a star. That's it. There are some stars are shining bright. There's some stars are shining brighter. And there's the one pole star. It's very rare. There's only one pole star. And there was a different era. This is a different era. The generations have changed. the wonderful young girls and boys.
Well, nowadays people. Some kind of generation has
yeah,
also come
the wonderful here. Generation, they all know, they are in tune with what's happening in the world, the satellite, the television, the world has come closer, even the travel is so closer. And suddenly there'll be a boy and a girl who say, look, we are there, and they'll be there.
In recent years, so many countries have been disturbed through the terror activities. What do you think, what should be the measures can be taken into consideration, can be applied to bring peace in our country? About
I think the whole world is passing through a phase of unrest and bit of violence. What's happened in England? Aren't things happening in India as well? Things are happening here.
How can we?
I think generation has to be educated. A younger generation, which is not wise enough, they're led astray by some opportunists. I think if they're properly educated, they realize it. They must motivate their minds to things which are better in terms of society, in terms of living, in terms of the well-being of themselves and for the country.
So you may know that recently His Majesty's King has taken a very successful and serious steps for the sake and peace of this countrymen. How do you react about this taken?
I think for the sake of discipline and for the sake of development of the nation, and for the sake of the interest of the country at large, I think a step has to be taken. Your king should be a very restless man, because he must be thinking for hours and hours, spending sleepless nights, thinking about what should be done to reconstruct and to build a country like Nepal. I think destiny has given him a chance to build Nepal. And then I'm going to tell him this evening, that you have come to a stage where you have to be called immortal by leaving something for your country, which he's going to do, I'm very sure. That's why he's taken this step. So nobody wants destruction. Everybody wants to build. Mm-hmm. And building is difficult. Destroying is very easy. So I think there must be wonderful things in his heart and his mind.
And
I want to discuss with him, because I'm on my first trip here. Because I've been reading newspapers. And I'm sure he must be having a great grand plan in his mind for his country, to forge ahead and be one of the important countries in the world.
Then do you believe this kind of steps have an easier way to bring the peace in our country?
I think the ultimate game is the peace. Who doesn't want peace? Everybody, every sane man in the world wants peace. Who doesn't want peace?
Well, sir,
peace is the only thing that can stabilize. If there's peace in the world, this heaven on this earth. We should all work towards that heaven.
एनटीभी 2 मा हाम्रा टेलिफिल्महरु पुनः प्रसारण हुँदैछन्। अब एनटीभी 2 मा भेटौँला।
नमस्कार दर्शक महानुभावहरु, हाम्रो महायात्राको 25 वर्षको सिलसिलामा नेपाल टेलिभिजनको दोस्रो च्यानल एनटीभी 2 बाट हाम्रा टेलिफिल्महरु पुनः प्रसारण हुँदैछन् र निकट भविष्यमा हाम्रा नयाँ टेलिसिरियलहरु पनि लिएर यहाँहरुसँग भेटघाट गर्ने नै छौँ। हेर्दै गर्नु होला, माया नमार्नु होला। नमस्ते।
मतावरी सोचो बोल दी ना सुने मनचे संग दिल खोल दी ना मुसुक्का हासी देव फूल फूले जाई ओ पानी पर पाची को आकाश खुले जाई।
हाय, आई एम कुमार सानो, यू आर वाचिंग मी एनटीवी 2 मेट्रो।
Have become so many producer, director, writer, actor as well. So you might have collected so many your experience over there. So did you remember your old memories when you started walking? When did you start?
I remember I'm writing a big book, a huge book of my own memoirs. Mm-hmm. It's a great hell of an experience. 60 years of being in active business is very rare. So I'm still on. My temperament is the same. I'm the same Devanand. How can Devanand change? Same philosophy, same style, same thinking. I'm maturer. My thinking is better. I'm wiser, wiser with my experiences, and I'm better in my own craft. Because I've learned from through my mistakes. But nobody's ever perfect.
Can you recall your memories when you did films, when you became a stars? Where did you start?
I struggled. I came as a loner. I came from Lahore. No. Lahore was then not in Pakistan, it was one India. Then India got divided in 1947. And I got my first break as a star in 1945. So when India got independence, I was a star already. So I've seen the development of my own country in terms of its own freedom. And the essence of it, now you see my latest picture, I've talked about politics in Mr. Prime Minister. I've played it, I've directed it, I've written it, I produced it. I'm going to bring it here, show it to you all.
So which one of the films made you quite a super hit star after the independence? I think before, you were still a star.
Yes.
Though, but after the independence.
I think you have a lot of big stars in our country, both male and female. You must be seeing a lot of popular films. You have good male stars, very popular stars, good actors, good actresses. But every era, every decade has new stars.
In this opportunity of commemorating Nepalese films, have you have an opportunity to see Nepalese films, sir?
Unfortunately, not yet, because Bombay doesn't have the chance. Mm-hmm. But here, I'm here for 3-4 days. If it's a good Nepalese picture and they want to show it to me, I'd love to see it. I'd like to see how much of growth of creativity is in your Nepali films.
Not. Well, how do you like the behavior of the actors, all these persons who are related to the films?
When I came to shoot, there were no films being made. Mm-hmm. Now the films being made. I met a lot of people. I met some of your directors. I saw some stars on the stage last evening, so I'm excited. I'd like to meet that, probably meet them and discuss with them.
Well, what can be the steps can be taken to develop the Nepalese film industry?
Go on making
Big Brother India.
I think India means well, and I think there's no difference, the same sentiment in Nepal as the sentiment in India. And I think you can even have collaboration deals, your subject matters are very understandable in India also. Mm-hmm. It's the same religion, same language, same emotions, same relationships. You just have some very bold, important directors to make films, so the India also wants to see them. You can dub them, you can send them international film festivals. You should hold international film festivals here.
Which place do you like mostly in Nepal?
Depends on where I want to go.
It all depends. Pokhara.
Pokhara is beautiful. I shot there. Mountains beautiful. I shot there. Kathmandu itself is beautiful. It's very very typical. So every place, it depends upon what you're looking for. And if you find something that you're looking for, becomes the most beautiful in your mind at that moment. But there's so much variety in Nepal. It's absolutely out of the world. Tremendous variety. We shot it in Bombay, city of Bombay, and that city is no more there, the city's grown. If you see Taxi Driver, it's a city of 50 years ago. If you see Bombay now, Bombay's changed. Like, I was looking for locations for Rama and Krishna, it's become bigger and greater, so it happens.
So, can you say your plans for next plans to come Nepal making films?
I am coming back. I have some plans. This a little too early to spell them out.
When will you have
a good opportunity? Very soon. I'm going back with a lot of wonderful notes in my mind. I'll quietly sit down, isolate myself, and then come out with something that will be fabulous for both the countries, for India and Nepal, and for motion picture making, for the world market.
नेपाली पनि त्यति शुद्ध छैन अब मैले नेपाली सिनेमामा नेपाली त राम्ररी बोल्न सक्नु पर्यो नि
त्यो आफूलाई सुधार्ने मान्छेमा योग्यता छैन भनेदेखि अरूलाई कसरी सुधार्छ त
जस्तो आन्तरिक द्वन्द्वहरू छन् त्यसमा उहाँहरूले चाहिँ के वाइ डन्ट दे बिकम द मेडिएटर बिट्विन द गभर्मेन्ट एन्ड द द्याट फ्याक्टर
एजुकेसन अझै कन्टिन्यू गर्नु बाँकी नै छ अहिलेदेखि मैले मेरो फ्युचरको एनालाइसिस गर्न सक्दिनँ
मिस नेपाल भयो टिभीमा एङ्कर मात्रै बनेर भएन
यो मिस नेपाल कसैले च्यारिटी गर्न र सोसियल वर्क गर्न दे डोन्ट ह्याभ टु विन अ क्राउन
महिमाजी बडा मुस्कान छँदै हुनुहुन्छ
एनटिभी टूमा एनटिभी टूमा हाम्रा टेलिफिल्महरू पुनः प्रसारण हुँदैछन् अब एनटिभी टूमा भेटौँला
नमस्कार दर्शक महानुभावहरू हाम्रो महायात्राको 25 वर्षको सिलसिलामा नेपाल टेलिभिजनको दोस्रो च्यानल एनटिभी टूबाट हाम्रा टेलिफिल्महरू पुनः प्रसारण हुँदैछन् र निकट भविष्यमा हाम्रा नयाँ टेलिसिरियलहरू पनि लिएर यहाँहरूसँग भेटघाट गर्ने नै छौँ. हेर्दै गर्नुहोला, माया नमार्नुहोला. नमस्ते.
आइदेऊ मेरो जीवनमा, आइदेऊ लाइदेऊ चोखो माया लाइदेऊ. Hi, this is James. You're watching NTV2 Metro.
Pinon Media ko prastuti Sani Dhapa Magaresa. Ramra Ramra Prahasan. Chossa Chossa. Hansha Vyangya. साथमा लोकगीत पप गीत आधुनिक गीतको कार्यक्रम सानी धप मगरेसा प्रत्येक शनिबार बेलुकी 8:45 बजे NTV2 मेट्रोमा, प्रत्येक सोमबार दिउँसो 12 बजे नेपाल टेलिभिजन.
लुक, इन अ डेमोक्रेसी लट अफ थिङ्स ह्यापन बिकज इट्स डेमोक्रेसी. द लट अफ वोइसेस, वोइसेस अफ डिसेन्ट, वोइसेस अफ नेगेसन, वोइसेस अफ पोजिटिभनेस. बट अल्टिमेटली वेन द ग्रोथ इज देयर, when the development is there, everything else should be forgotten.
Can a Nepalese can go in Indian cinema to give a performance? Someone might come also in Bollywood.
Manisha Kavala is here. They could do some more, you never know. Because you've got lovely faces here. Nepal is a handsome country, you must know that. And it's a very varied country from place to place to place to place. Mm-hmm. I've traveled from north to south to east to west.
We have come to know that there are so many films are being made by you. What's your next plan, sir?
I'm planning something. I'll come back and tell you. Because listen, I'm here for the last 2 or 3 days. And I'm a very aware man. Mm-hmm. I'm a very thinking person. And I keep toying with the ideas. And the moment those ideas materialize, and I say, I want to do this, there's nothing, then there's nobody can stop me at that moment. Give me a few days, a few weeks, and you'll get to know. You'll be the first person to know.
Can you highlight your own love, your own inner feelings about Nepal and Nepalese people? How do you be here? I mean,
the very fact I'm here, it means I love Nepal. They telephoned to me, come over, and I said, I'll come. Even if I had not got the award, I would still be here. Because I was very busy, I could not come, but you gave me an opportunity to come. I'm so busy, so I came, and since I'm here, now everything's getting refreshed in my mind.
So what do you do besides films?
Film is very involving. Film is writing, film is directing, film is planning, film is thinking, film is futuristic, film is music, film is painting, film is the mass mind, film is leadership, film is inspiring the world through your media, giving thoughts that nobody else has given. So when you give thoughts to the world that nobody else has given, sometimes they don't hit out, they are flops. But still, you have given thoughts and people think about it. It's hell of a medium. There's no better medium in the world for the world to conquer emotionally than the film medium. That's for sure.
Well, at last, can you give any message to our youngsters who wants to come in films?
Come into the movies. Try your luck. Motivate your mind. Say what you want to do. And say you want to do this, then follow it up and you'll get it. And don't get dejected with temporary setbacks. You may not get your break in a quick hurry, but don't lose patience, because after all, out of millions, only one star is born. My very best, my greetings to Nepal Television and to all the viewers who are watching this program, and my good wishes to them for their well-being and for their future, and be happy and smiling all the time. It's a great country, and keep on building it up and take it to the skies. Thank you.
Well, viewers, we were watching the interview of living legend of Indian cinema, heartthrob of millions of viewers around the world, and the one and only evergreen star of Indian cinema, Dev Anand. How do you like this interview? Write to us at the following address: Nepal Television, Post Box number 3826, Singhadarbar, Kathmandu, Nepal. Until the next time, I am Pralhad signing you out of this special edition of a special program. Namaste.